Tell me what happened when the doors opened at Auschwitz.
Well, before the doors was opening, I mean, we heard the train screeched, and then we all of a sudden they came and they knocked at the doors, and we heard voices, dogs barking, and you know, Jewish language, German language, you know, arouse, you know, it's on it. And then there were people were jumping in, and dogs were jumping in with them. And they were screaming and yelling, arouse, 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 you know, and you were confused, you know, there was nothing. And one guy who walked in, it must have been a prisoner, says to me in Yiddish, hast du gold? Hast du brillanten? Do I have gold or do I have diamonds? I looked at the guy, is he crazy or something? And then I saw people been thrown out of there. And I saw older people, they had to go and jump out of the train. The platform was low, and the train was high, and people were beaten. And then when he walked out of there, when finally he got out of the train, out of those boxcars, all of a sudden there was a stench hit you. You didn't know what that is. And nobody told you what is going to happen. Nobody told you where you are, what's going on. The only thing that you saw, we saw SS, and we saw prisoners in striped clothes. And I saw dogs who were sniffling. And I saw people being beaten up, and they tell you to stand in line, and then way in a distance you hear music, a band playing. My God, it was such a confusion. I mean, you didn't know what was going on. So then finally, after we were all out of the train, I remember my mother and father were next to me, and my brothers, three of us. No, four of us, six of us, we were together. And this man came, this tall SS man, and he pointed with a finger. He put the three of us, the three older brothers together, and my little kid brother there. He was with us. And I told my little brother, I said to him, Sally, gay to Tati and Mommy. Go with my... And like a little kid, he followed. He did.